A sampler, no, an audio editor, no, a stems separator. Well, Samplab 2 is all of that, and it uses online AI to analyze its audio. It can do a lot of very cool stuff and also needs some improvements. More on that later. First, let's go over what Samplab 2 globally can do. Samplab 2 works as either a standalone app or as a plugin inside your DAW. In your DAW, you can find it as an instrument, not as an effect. To start, drag and drop your audio file into Samplab. The AI will analyze tempo and key, and you can decide if you want a stem separation and which stems you want. Press OK and the AI will do stem separation and MIDI extraction. Depending on how long your track is, this can take a little while. This 53 seconds long track took about 20 seconds and I'm on a lightning fast 1 GB internet connection. Quick note for Cubase users when you want to use the plugin version. Make sure you set Samplab to not be always on top when you import samples, otherwise drag and drop won't work. This isn't a Samplab issue but a Cubase issue, I have it with other plugins as well. When you change the being on top, not being on top, the plugin goes to black and you need to reopen. Also, every time you open the plugin, it takes a little time to process, which got a little bit on my nerves after doing it a couple of times. Now, what's cool about Samplab is that the program will split the audio in adjustable MIDI notes as well. At first, you see all notes in one MIDI track separated by colors per instrument and drums. By pressing here, you can split up these tracks, which I think really helps with the clarity of knowing what you're editing. The separation quality depends on, as is normal with stem separation software, on which audio track you use. All of these notes you see are adjustable, which is very powerful. You can quickly change pitch. Or edit out some parts. Let's butcher these awesome drums into a 4 on the floor. Find the best parts and move them into place. By clicking here, the samples will snap to the grid. If you press Ctrl and rotate your mouse wheel, you get vertical zoom. Let's adjust the bass guitar. And remember, all these samples and sounds are extracted from one stereo audio file. You can do a lot of the syncing and note adjusting inside Samplab, obviously. And the standalone version will be perfect for that. But I assume you probably want to do some mixing with the tracks you adjust or create anyway. So using Samplab in your DAW has many benefits. Before we get to that, make sure to subscribe to this channel to stay up to date on the latest new cool plugins. Cover songs is probably one of the many types of songs you would love to do, but uploading to a streaming platform is always a hassle due to copyrights and required fee because you cover an original song. DistroKid makes this very easy for you by offering the option to do this all for you for $12 per song per year when you have a DistroKid subscription. Use my link in the description to get 7% off of your first year on a DistroKid. Now in your DAW, you get drag and drop functions. This is very handy for quick workflow, but I ran into some issues with Cubase 12 on Windows 11. When you drag and drop MIDI from Samplab into Cubase, all works fine. Hold Ctrl to do that. When you want to do the same with audio, you need to press Shift. But it doesn't drop the audio file on your timeline in Cubase. This can be a Cubase issue or Samplab. Let me know how it works for you. Now, if you drag and drop MIDI, you can of course use the MIDI to let any other instrument play. Result may vary though, depending on how well Samplab extracted audio. It can work well or it can get messy. If you drag and drop from the export menu here, it does work in Cubase. But in both cases, the export is first done in the default Samplab folder, which is documents/samplab/exports, which I only found out later. And then are imported into Cubase, which creates two files in total instead of one. Now you can export stems and the mix from inside Samplab, but then it won't import on your timeline without doing it manually. Also, drag and drop and export all are in 16-bit. There's no way I can change that. I prefer to work in 24-bit, so there's always a conversion happening. An option to set that bitrate is most welcome. Another annoyance is that Samplab doesn't remember the last folder you exported to. I am used to do that with basically any app or program on Windows, but you always default to documents/samplab/exports. You can zoom in and zoom out on both app and plugin by using Ctrl or Command plus and minus. And I found out I couldn't get to zoom in on the standalone version. After going back and forth with the developers and mail, it was suggested to use the Shift key as well, since keyboard layout may differ, and that worked for that. But inside Cubase, I don't have to do that, and it works as it should. They also mentioned they might drop this zoom in, zoom out functionality, but I opted to keep it because it's always handy to have. We'll see how that develops in the future. Now, maybe a lot of the things I encountered are easily fixed, but documentation on how to use the plugin is somewhat lackluster, other than some quick tutorial videos. So how does the stem separation sound? Well, as usual, it depends on the material you use. For instance, here, Samplab totally misses a part of the vocal. Drums sound somewhat aliased. But on this track, it actually extracts the bass guitar amongst the best I have heard in stem separation softwares. I'm an asshole in your stomach. There are way more creative applications for Samplab I didn't cover in this video, but you will get an idea of how Samplab works. The audio tracks I used for the stem separation checks I also used to compare other stem separation programs. Find these in the video which is displayed on screen and linked in the description below.